Deputy Chief Justice Philomena Mwilu, who was arraigned in court last week, arrested actually. And let's begin with the latest being a trove of emails that have gone to show the ties or the dalliance between the DCJ and Imperial Bank. Let's get more from our senior political affairs reporter, Duncan Heimer.
Deputy Chief Justice Philomena Mwilu's defense team has finally managed to rescue her from the Director of Public Prosecution's noose, abruptly halting her prosecution from alleged abuse of office and corruption-related offenses. The Anti-Corruption Court has accepted High Court orders to stay the matter, at least for now. Her 34-man defense team successfully managed to wiggle her out of taking in what was a career-threatening plea on 13 counts leveled against her.
In compliance with the said order, this Honorable Court gives the following directions: that this proceeding shall now rest at the point at which they are reached, that the status quo shall be maintained in respect of any orders the Court had made so far.
Among other things, Mwilu is accused of forgery, tax evasion, and abuse of office in relation to commercial transactions with the collapsed Imperial Bank, a move the DPP has vehemently opposed.
Experience to see the difficulties and the challenges prosecutors face in prosecuting high-profile cases. And when we say that the cases are not moving, it's not because of us. It is our law, it is our constitution, which we must abide by.
Lady Justice Mwilu obtained the orders after arguing that her being taken to court is part of a scheme by President Uhuru Kenyatta to avenge her vote for nullifying the 2017 August 8th presidential election. In an affidavit filed in court by the Okongo Omogeni and Company law firm, Mwilu is quoted as saying, immediately following the determination of the Supreme Court of Kenya in the 1st September 2017, on the same day, none other than the President of the Republic of Kenya, Uhuru Kenyatta, made public statements issuing both explicit and implicit threats against the majority of judges who decided the outcome of the presidential petition. The affidavit goes ahead to say, I verily believe to be true that the fact that charges brought to me, though fashioned as corruption and economic crimes, were in fact investigated and filed through the office of the Inspector General of Police, over whom the first respondent exercises constitutional powers of control and direction. Based on that principle, the prosecution against me cannot stand, having been tainted by illegalities from the start. On Thursday, the Deputy Chief Justice reported for duty as usual, as confirmed to KTN by Chief Registrar of the Judiciary, Anne Amadi, a confirmation that until October 9th, Philomena Mwilu continues business as usual. It is a huge sigh of relief for the Deputy Chief Justice Philomena Mwilu after her team of 34 advocates successfully rescued her from the DPP's noose. For now, she remains afloat. But for how long will this last, or will she still be dragged before the legal gallows? Duncan Hemba, KTN News.
All right, let's begin from that affidavit by the DCJ dismiss, and she's making these accusations against the president to the effect that this is a witch hunt. What do you say to this?
Well, you know, there is certainly that Philomena knows quite a lot that all of us do not know. But when you're looking at the larger picture, is an issue of corruption. And in my view, the DPP has made a strategic error in his judgment. That in as much as we want to fight corruption, it should have a priority matrix. Because majority of Kenyans right now are not really worried about the personal commercial transactions of an individual judge, but they are worried over massive corruption at Kenya Pipeline corruption. Mm-hmm. They are worried over corruption at Ruaraka. They are worried over corruption over the importation of sugar to Kenya. And they're just worried that a third of our budget disappears into public servants' pockets. That, in my view, should be the priority. And that's where the DPP should be looking at. Number two, Chapter 6 is very important. And I guess that's how the DCJ comes in. Mm-hmm. And it's on, if you look at history, you look at jurisprudence, and you speak to lawyers who are highly regarded in society, they say, if you want a court in Kenya to entertain a criminal matter on a judge, then you go through the Judicial Service Commission. Mm-hmm. Let the Judicial Service Commission handle the matter, then they'll request the judge to resign or defy him, whatever they want to do. Then now, as an ordinary Kenyan, as a Wanjiko, as a Mura, then you can arraign that person before court. It's a best practice. There's even a case quoted from Nigeria that if you want to take a judge through a criminal proceeding, make sure there is no longer a judge, then you can go through the process. If you look at the Chief Magistrate, Lawrence Mugambi, he finds himself in a very awkward, almost intimidating position. Essentially, you've got your boss before you. How do you prosecute this? And I would easily bet my head that if it was a normal Wanjiko arrested, he would have not been out on a personal bond of 5 million. But Mugambi found himself before the boss, and what can he do? For all practical purposes, it doesn't make sense. And in my view, we should look as critical at what the DPP is saying and pat him on the back for fighting corruption, but the review is priorities. Mm-hmm. Because when you look at Justice Mwilu and the issue, while we know that judges in Kenya are supposed to be like Caesar's wife beyond reproach, but this is a commercial transaction, and I don't know whether or not Imperial Bank is actually aggrieved. Because if there's somebody who's supposed to be pursuing this matter, it's supposed to be Imperial Bank. So this is something which can be sorted out in a civil way, mm-hmm, or in an administrative manner. I mean, no way suggesting that Mwilu would be, you know, innocent, because we don't have all the material facts.
Yes.
But looking at the resources at the DPP's disposal, priority should be on this massive corruption. I mean, the DPP is running after 12 million that Mwilu is accused of, and is letting a trillion disappear into people's pockets. If you do a basic opinion poll that Kipchumba doesn't like by Ipsos as to whether we should be going for this 12 million or going for 1 trillion, I suspect majority of Kenyans would say, let's go for 1 trillion.
Right.
But be that as it may, the integrity of public officials must be highly respected. I mean, like these emails, what they seem to suggest is that she used the social capital to have decisions made in her favor.
Right.
She used her position in society to get a relative or somebody employed at Imperial Bank who was acting as a special purpose vehicle. But in my view, the DPP, if he has a priority matrix,
yes,
go for Ruaraka, go for these guys who made erroneous decisions on killing our sugar sector. I mean, Makia would be reluctant to admit that his neighbors back in the village are using sugarcane for firewood. Others have committed suicide because of erroneous decisions taken by Rotich.
That's more important. Yeah.
The same Rotich who's taking decisions so that we have a 16% increase on fuel cost is the same Rotich who allowed Tom, Dick and Harry to